Hello everyone. This is the first video of my Scope Cafe channel. So today I prepare Scope and Function Generator, but today I do not use this one. So turn off this instrument. So what I use today is only Whiteboard. Using Whiteboard, I want to introduce some basics about understanding of waveforms. Okay, here we go. Here's my whiteboard. I want to buy a grid type, but I cannot find, so I write a line. So sorry for not clean. At first, I want you to write graph of the 1 kHz, 1 volt peak sine wave. Of course, I write on this whiteboard, but please write by yourself. Okay, start writing. Okay, so the maximum point is 0.5 volt and minimum point is minus 0.5. One period is 0.001 because frequency is 1 kHz. So what type of graph do you write? To tell the truth, answer is not only one. I wrote a graph with 1.5 period, depend on the grid number. But of course, you can write much more, like... It looks something strange. Write again. It do not reach 0.5 volt. It looks many distortion. Okay, count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so it is 0.005. Of course, this is correct answer. I said sine wave, but I did not mention about the starting point. So you can start from another point, like a sine wave. Okay, this is also a correct answer. So there's an answer of increasing the number of periods, and also answer of starting another phase, and writing less than one period is also correct answer. Oh, too much distortion. Okay, like this graph with half period is also correct, but How can I say? We can guarantee that after this half period, this is really like this waveform. It might become square wave from here, or return to top again. Yeah, it is also a common waveform. So, how can I say? It is correct answer, but not perfect. But anyway, we can consider some types of waveforms about the 1 kHz, 1 volt peak to peak, sine waves. So today, I asked you to write down a graph of the 1 kHz, 1 volt peak to peak sine wave. What you write in the first is what you want to see on an oscilloscope screen when checking the waveform of 1 kHz, 1 volt peak peak sine wave. The other graphs are waveforms which you can recognize the waveform is 1 kHz, 1 volt peak to peak sine wave. So if oscilloscope shows a different type waveform on a screen, maybe you cannot recognize the waveform is 1 kHz, 1 volt peak to peak sine wave. So how much you can recognize the meaning of waveform is the difference of using oscilloscope or mastering oscilloscope. Okay, so if the waveform is very simple, like today's waveform, sine wave, so it is not so large problem. But in real waveform is not so simple, especially you are using oscilloscope when you have finding some fault, like a noise or something, a waveform is saturated here. Let's consider the debugging process. So when such kind of fault is caused, we will bring a oscilloscope and find the root cause. For that purpose, you have to adjust the oscilloscopes for displaying the waveform of your interest as better as possible. Next, you have to understand the meaning of the waveform. Oscilloscope guide mainly focus on adjusting oscilloscope, but I think understanding waveform is also important things. So today, I start this oscilloscope channel from writing graphs. I hope this video become a good chance of linking waveform in your mind and real waveform. Thank you for watching this video and see you next week. Bye.